Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaur Krishna E Krishna Karna Sindhu Dina Bandha Jagatpate O Krishna Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanta Nagaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Rishabhanusata Devi Pranamami Hari Jayatam Suratam Mama Vandavate Ragati Matsaravasya Padam Moja Radha Vrindavaneshwari Divya Vrindaranya Kalpa Dramada Shiva Ratnagaram Simhasanastho Shishirara Govinda Deva Krishna Adivisivya Manoswara Shimanadasara Sarambhi Vansi Vatatastita Karsana Venu Swadair Gopir Gopinashriyastuna Vandayaya Tulasidibhaya Priyaya Keshavashya Krishna Bhakti Vraj Devi Sattamattaye Namo Panchatattvatmakam Krishnam Bhaktarupasarupakam Bhaktaptaram Bhaktakhyam Nami Bhakta Shaktikam
I was so much worried for you that I'm not going there. How she will be? She will forget and me. But I cannot forget. You can forget.
No, we did not forget.
How is your husband?
No.
Is he here?
No, he didn't come.
He couldn't come.
And who is she?
This is Anuradha.
Your daughter?
Come on, don't be
shy. Yes, yeah, kind of. She's a friend of mine from Eugene. Yeah. Yeah. She came here. This is her daughter.
How are you? How is my mother?
She's getting old now, but she's okay.
Very jolly.
But she always remembers.
You have to prepare something with her for me.
Okay.
You are not here for
a few days.
You are coming to Bejar also?
No.
Why not?
That's what I said.
You must come.
Yes. Video.
How are you working there?
My daughter will live at least 7 days with me.
Otherwise, she has nothing to eat.
So you should be. He will chastise you.
No, that's not my husband. I'm
from Vrindavan.
He was in Vrindavan Gokula for many years.
Oh, I've seen you.
Yeah.
Question is?
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
भारतीय रहने वाला था तो हिंदी जानता है
हाँ
भारतीय था पहले
हाँ भारतीय अभी भी भारतीय
अच्छा ठीक तुम गोकुल में पढ़ता था क्या नाम
है हरिओम
now where you live
I live in Eugene right now but I came to teach in Bangalore
Nido Bhagavan Nido Bhagavan
Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananyanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Jina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Vanchakalpatrubhyascha Kripasindhubhyayivacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Mahabhadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Bhakti Tattva Vivek. Bhukti Mukti Spriha Javat Pisachi Hridi Vartati Tavat Bhakti Sukhasyatra Katham Abhidayo Bhavit. I wanted to explain whole book, but it will take so much time. And the subject is some philosophical. So some of you cannot have so much taste for this. But it is the platform, just like to make a platform for bhakti. So I wanted to explain, but here only today and after one day, then we will go to Beja. So I'm going to explain some special things, the essence, something that how we can follow this, but try to follow it very strictly. If you are not following all these things and chanting only 16 round and not doing anything else or reading some books, it will not do. We should try to make this platform. I know that some devotees taking afim, ganja, also wine, but they cover all these things that anyone cannot see. But their faces show, tell very
clearly.
All cannot
read.
Read, but some can read. So you are cheating yourself. So try to be very bold and very strong in these things. Don't take all these things. Otherwise Kali will be there. Now I'm coming to, we have told that there are three aspects of Paratattva, Advaya Jnana Paratattva. Brahma, Paramatma and Bhagavan. Among three, Brahma, Bhagavan, Paripurna Sarvashakti Visisht Bhagavan iti. When that Paratattva is Paripurna, meaning with whole his energies, potencies, qualities, roop, gun, lila and all other things, then he is called Bhagavan. When he enters partly in the hearts of jivas, like Sakshi, then he becomes Paramatma. And when we see only through Gyan, then he becomes like Brahma. But these two aspects, devotees should not have any link with them. The object of the pure bhakti is Bhagavan. In also Bhagavan, there are two kinds of Bhagavan. Bhagavan is one, but two aspects. Where Swarup Shakti is fully there with Supreme Personality of Godhead, all kinds of opulence are there. So it is called Aishwarya, Aishwarya, like Parabhyam Narayan, that aspect. And where there is Swarup Shakti in his fullest, what?
Most complete.
In sweet mood, then it is called Madhurya. Look here, what is written there?
Where the internal potency, Swarup Shakti, displays its complete opulence, Aishwarya, there Bhagavan appears as Vaikunthanath Narayan. And where the internal potency displays its supreme sweetness, Madhurya, there Bhagavan appears as Sri Krishna.
Go on.
In spite of being predominant almost everywhere, Aishwarya loses its charm in the presence of Madhurya.
In this world, everywhere, opulence is more powerful than sweet things. But no example of where opulence is covered with what?
Sweetness.
Sweet thing. Not example. Only we can see opulence and we will be charmed. Oh, it is so opulence. But in world, sometimes a sublime abhas,
semblance
kind we can see. That I have forgotten the name of that prince of England.
Prince Charles.
He has love for any lady. But lady was not lord family. No? A prince can marry that lady, but he will not be the king of England. That was banned. And at that time, whole world like everywhere, British rule was there. Then Parliament told him that you can marry, but you will be deprived of whole being emperor. And he kicked that opulence. And he preferred love to that lady. This is something abhas.
A reflection.
Not reflection, service. Perverted reflection light. But there in Vrindavan, Golok Vrindavan, always opulence is defeated by
sweetness.
This Madhurya mood. Always. So, in this world, there is no example of this Madhurya mood, very little, rare. So, all we are attracted to opulence. not to see, very hard. And those who are like this, they are called araganuga, only by lobe. If anything will come in your heart for this Madhurya Bodh, he will always reject
opulence,
always reject. Even he has a little mood, little attraction or greed for that. But it is very rare in this world. Here, bhukti mukti spriha javat, he is telling that these are two kinds of what? You should read the meaning.
As long as the two witches of the desires for bhukti and mukti remain in a devotee's heart.
What name? Pishachi?
Witches.
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 Witch.
What is called witches?
Putana.
Pishachini. In Western Kirtani, they are?
Yeah, they have.
They have?
They go on broom. They drive in broom.
Jhadu ki upar urti hain hawa mein. Jadu ko na janti hain.
Achha.
They give curses.
They are everywhere.
I knew that in India only Pishachis are there.
No, in Western Kirtani more than India.
If bhukti and mukti, what bhukti?
Desire for sense
gratification in any way, and to desire mukti, any kind of mukti. These are two very great wishes. If bhakti will see that they are there, she will never look there and never come. Bhakti is like a very soft, teeny-aged brajabalika.
Baby girl.
Huh?
Like a little baby girl.
Baby girl. Very tender. Soft. Not teeny-aged, but...
Tender.
Just born.
Just born. Very beautiful, very sweet, but very... and
delicate.
Soft.
Delicate.
If any dhup jor se aa jaye,
strong sunshine.
Hotness. Or anything, she will be murjha jayegi. She will be faint. Faint pani murjhana?
Shrink.
Yeah. Murjhana means by?
Withered.
So, where there is a little smell of these things too, bhakti will never come. But we see that he is chanting, remembering, he has been initiated by anyone, any devotee. Sometimes he weeps. Sometimes, chanting so, Hare Krishna, walking so much. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. As if he is upset. Sometimes, Srila Narahari Prabhu, one of the best disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati and friend of my Gurudev, Narahari Prabhu. If you see that anyone is chanting Hare Krishna, restless here, going and here, then you should think that he will not be in mud now, he will give up this mud forever and he will go anywhere. This is the symptom, sometimes. So, these are pisachi. They will eat us, not eat us, but swallow.
Devour.
Devour us. whole, and bhakti will go away forever. So, gone. Kayik bachi. Then Sarup Siddha Bhakti will not come. It may be that Sangha Siddha or Arup Siddha will come. Can you tell what is
Arup Siddha
and Sangha Siddha?
Arup means to superimpose, so as like...
More loudly as you speak.
For example, if there's somebody who likes to garden, then they think, I will garden so many beautiful vegetables and flowers because I like to garden, that is my propensity. And when the vegetables have grown, then I will offer to Thakurji.
Yes. Yes. Those who are actually not Sarupa Siddha Bhakti, Shramanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pad Sivanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Atmanivedan, or 64 kinds of bhakti, or 5 kinds of bhakti, 3 kinds of bhakti, Nam Sankirtan. Really, there is not. But we are thinking that to make a garden is bhakti, because by that I will serve partly to Krishna. I will make a goshala for 1,000 cows, and some of milk, 1 kilo, I will give daily to Thakur, and rest I will
enjoy.
So make a garden, to make a goshala is not among the 64 kinds of bhakti. There are not. But if actually I have offered myself in the lotus feet of my Gurudev and Krishna, and then making any garden fully to serve, then it is bhakti. Where I am doer, and all things are mine, and among them something I am taking and offering to Krishna. This is Arup Siddha Bhakti. No? Like Jat Karoshi, Jadashnashi, Jajjuhoshi, Dadashi Tap, Jat Tapasyas Kanteya Tad Kurusya Madharapanam. You should, arpan means?
Offer
me.
But if someone is offering nearly everything, if someone is offering nearly everything,
but not himself.
Even it is Arup Siddha. You are doer of all these things? You are not doer of it. You are the eternal servant of Krishna. Eternal. So your everything will be for Krishna. You are not doer. I am doing anything to please Krishna because I am him. This mood be there. Otherwise, Arup Siddha Bhakti. And Sangha Siddha Bhakti? What is Sangha Siddha?
Sangha Siddha Bhakti means, for example, I am not a devotee, I am not Vaishnava. But if I come into the Sangha of Vaishnavas, then some of their qualities will come into me, like humility and charity.
Can you tell?
Well, my understanding is that Sangha Siddha means that someone is developing the qualities which are favorable for Vaishnavism, but there is not actual bhakti manifestation of those qualities.
Like this. Okay? Or anything more you can tell?
Sangha Siddha means that which is...
Very carefully you should hear all.
Sangha said that means that which is associated with devotion. So, just like in Shikshastak, it is said, Trinadapi Sunichena Tarorapi Sahishnana Amanina Manadena Kirtaniya Sadahari. So, as one is performing bhakti, there are different qualities which are said to be qualities of the devotee, like humility, tolerance, peacefulness, kindness to others, nonviolence, etc. So if one is exhibiting these different qualities with some connection to devotion, they'll be known as Sanghasiddha Bhakti. But those qualities in and of themselves are not bhakti.
Yes, sir, say, where there is no Sarup Siddha Bhakti, nothing Sarup Siddha Bhakti, Samadhan Kirtanam Vishnu Vishmaranam. But these are in devotees something, like 26 kinds of qualities, which has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam. Kripalu, Akrita Droha, Satya, Sar, Mauni, and all other things. They are really no bhakti, Sarup Siddha, Saramanam Kirtanam Vishnu. They are helpful. So, if they are with bhakti, they are also called bhakti, but Sangha Siddha Bhakti, not Sarup Siddha Bhakti. What I told?
You said that where the 26 qualities of the devotee are present.
These are not anywhere found them, not related, only one. That is related. And all 25 kinds of all these are like virtues, good virtues.
So where these 25 qualities are present in a devotee, that they are favorable to bhakti, but they in themselves, they are not Sarup Siddha Bhakti.
Yeah.
And you gave example of the renunciation of Raghunath Das Goswami.
Yeah.
That though he is Mahabhagavat, but his renunciation still is an example of Sangha Siddha.
His Vairagya and all other things. But he was in Raghunath Das Goswami, so his Vairagya is also natural and bhakti. But if separated from bhakti, that virtues, they are not bhakti. So, in this world,
when we are using this word Sangha Siddha Bhakti, this means when it is associated with Savrup Savrup Bhakti. When we use this term,
related, anyhow, then they will be called bhakti, but Sangha Siddha. We should know and try to differentiate them and try to follow Sarup Siddha Bhakti. And you can see that all virtues and all Arup Siddha Bhakti will come automatically in him, in Suddharu, in pure form. If he is doing brooming is not in any of bhakti. Brooming, but brooming will also be bhakti, pure bhakti. So anything done for Krishna pleasing, stool clearing, everything will be bhakti. If our bhakti is here pure. Now he is defining. Go on.
Question. In the Jiva Dharma, when the Mayavadi sannyasi comes into the association of the Vaishnava, he has so many good qualities from his practice of Dharma.
Yes.
So is this a case of Sangha Siddha Bhakti?
No. When he was in Kashi, performing all these things, it was for mukti. Yeah. They are helper of mukti. So they are not Sangha Siddha Bhakti. But when he came and he took initiation and he surrendered and he began to do Sarup Siddha Bhakti, then all bhakti was turned into bhakti, Sangha Siddha.
So then that became Sangha Siddha Bhakti.
But when he was pure devotee, then they were not Sangha Siddha.
So the same qualities, first they were Sangha Siddha, then they became Swarup Siddha.
Yeah. Yes, of God. इस जन्म में निरोग रहना सदृष्टु भोजन की प्राप्ति देयर भक्ति मुक्ति इज प्रिया वेर भक्ति मुक्ति इज प्रिया
या राइट आफ्टर दैट
हां
as long as the two witches of the desires for bhakti and mukti remain in a devotee's heart not even a fraction of the pure happiness derived from surupsita bhakti will arise
Go on.
Both bodily and mental enjoyment are considered bhakti. To make
What?
Both bodily and mental enjoyment are considered bhakti.
Bhakti. Go on.
To make an extraneous effort to remain free from disease.
Here. Don't talk. Again?
To make an extraneous effort to remain free from disease, to desire palatable foodstuffs, strength and power, wealth, followers, wife, sons and daughters, fame and victory are all considered bhakti.
Bhakti means?
Sense enjoyment.
Sense. All are. That I should be very healthy, a rich person. I will do this, that. All are what?
Bhukti.
In bhakti. And after death, what?
To desire to take one's next birth in a Brahmin family or in a royal family, to attain residence in the heavenly planets or in Brahmalok, or to obtain any other type of happiness in one's next life is also considered
any
bhukti.
Kind of happiness for me, for your own. All are included in bhakti. If you have, think yourself, then no bhakti. Very hard, very hard. But very easy. Go on.
Practice of the Eightfold Yoga System and to desire the 8 or 18 varieties of mystic perfections are also categorized as bhakti. The greed for bhakti forces the jiva to become subordinate to the 6 enemies headed by lust and anger. Envy easily takes over the heart of the jiva and rules it. Hence, to attain shuddha bhakti, one has to remain completely aloof from the desire for bhakti. To abandon the desire for bhakti, a conditioned soul need not reject the objects of the senses by going to reside in the forest.
What is the meaning? He told? What he told?
That one need not, to renounce the objects of the senses, one need not leave material world.
Kya mane hua?
That all those things of sense gratification, if we want to get rid of them. For this, it is not required that we should go to jungle and forest.
Then, what should we do?
Merely going to reside.
So, for this, we'll have to take sannyas or brahmachari life or go to dense forest. It is not essential. But there is something essential. What he's telling.
Merely going to reside in the forest or accepting the dress of a sannyasi will not free one from the desire for bhakti.
One? What meaning?
If we go.
Kya meaning? What is the meaning?
If one tries to dryly renounce.
If you are going to forest, dense forest. No?
Yes.
Bhukti knows the way where you have gone. He will take scent.
Smell.
And at once quickly follow you there also.
Attack you in there.
If you are even in water, ocean, anywhere in this
planet.
She will not, you will not get rid of that. If you are taking sannyasi vesh, tilak, mala, everything, quickly he will go there. He knows that he is actually not renowned. He has wish
to enjoy.
To enjoy.
To sense and enjoy sense. So simply at once go and follow him. And then lust will come, anger will come, all six enemies will come. And your bhakti will, if it is Shraddha, very little fraction of Shraddha, it will also go away. Mm-hmm. So be very careful for this. Only taking sannyas and red cloths or tilak mala, even initiation also taking. Oh, she knows that you have not taken initiation. What we take initiation by fire sacrifice is it is external. We should try to take it
internal.
So this mukti, this wishes, know whether he is a real devotee or not. If not, she will follow. Go on.
If bhakti resides in a devotee's heart, then even while living amidst the objects of the senses, he will be able to remain detached from them and will be capable of abandoning the desire for bhakti.
Bharat Maharaj left this world, went there. It may be that he has some attachment for world. So attachment there, it went to a dear boy, and he was dispelled from there. So we should think like this. Go.
Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami says, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Uruchim Uddhatastatra Janasya Bhajane Hare Vishayeshu Garishtopi Araga Prayo Viliyate Anasaktasya Vishayan Yatarham Upayunjataha Nirvanda Krishna Sambande Yuktam Vairagya Muchyate Prapanchikataya Buddhya Harisambandi Vastuna Mamukshu Viparityago Vairagyam Phalgukatyate.
These are slokas of Bhakti Rasami Sindhu of Rupa Goswami. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur always remember everywhere. For Vignas, this is important. Otherwise, bhakti will not come. Anasakta sabhishyan jat. No, you should read this meaning.
When the jiva,
oh, very, very attentively. Don't sleep. Don't be idle. Try to know.
When the jiva develops a taste for Krishna bhajan, at that time his excessive attachment for the objects of the senses starts gradually fading. Then with a spirit of detachment, he accepts the objects of the senses only according to his needs, knowing those objects to be related to Krishna and behaving accordingly. This is called Yukta Vairagya. The renunciation.
Anything knowing? What is Yukta Vairagya? Boliye to aap. What is Yukta Vairagya?
Accepting only those things which are favorable for our progress in the spiritual life and rejecting all those which are not. So, Yukta Vairagya means that we have to discriminate what we should use for Krishna and Guru service and others we should quit.
You? Yes.
To accept things.
More loudly.
To accept the object of the senses in the service of Krishna and engaging those things in the service of Krishna.
What he told?
To use the objects of the senses only in relationship to service of Krishna.
Thik bol raha. He's telling, okay?
Yukta Vairagya means appropriate renunciation. So it means to understand that everything belongs to Krishna, nothing belongs to me. Therefore, in that sense, there is nothing.
But not talking wholly, fully. Only what we require to maintain our life, we can take only. If you are going to Puri in Anand Bazar, have you seen Anand Bazar? You know the name? You all? Anand Bazar is the market of Mahaprasadam. So, varieties of preparations of laddu, puri, kachauri, so much dal, very delicious, and so many sweets, various kinds of sweets. And if you think that all are Mahaprasadam, so we should take daily all delicious foods up to here, then what will be? You cannot chant, you'll have to go to bed and like this. It may be that you'll be so fat, and then you can require of a very beautiful Seva Dasi. Seva Dasi, you know?
Seva Dasi.
Seva Dasi are beautiful boy, girl, friend.
Seva Dasi. Either Seva Dasi or Seva Dasi.
So we should not take all, only to maintain our life, we can take very little. And then praying, Mahaprasade, Govinde, Namabha. Not only uttering, taking it here. I'm not going to eat Mahaprasad, I'm going to serve. When I'm taking name, then I'm serving Krishna name. When I am reading any book, I'm serving Bhagavat. When I'm chanting name, I'm serving Krishna. Like this. Always serving mood. Then you'll get rid of Maya, otherwise not. Go on. So you should try to be, to follow Yukta Vairagya. But sometimes we do opposite to this. By the name of following Yukta Vairagya, we do everything. Like last third day, we played a
drama
of Gita Sansar. So we should not try to do. Very boldly and strongly we should try to follow this Yukta Vairagya. Raghunath Das Goswami was Yukta Vairagya. Gaur Krishov Das Babaji Maharaj.
Pundarik Vidyanidhi.
Pundarik Vidyanidhi. Raya Ramananda. All the devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Like this.
The renunciation of those who, desiring liberation from matter, reject the objects of the senses, considering them to be illusory, is called phalgu or useless.
What? Kya bole?
After sense gratification, if one comes to this conclusion that this is full of miseries, then he desires that we should give up sense gratification totally and get the liberation. And such type of desire of renunciation is phalgu, that is artificial vairagya.
You should again explain. Without seeing.
Just as Ramachandra Prabhu was saying, that if one is seeing that in engaging in sense gratification, one is getting so much misery, then, as it is stated here, one will see this as useless, and then they will falsely try to renounce without having the proper realization that ultimately everything is part of Krishna's energy and everything should be utilized in Krishna's service. So such dry renunciation is called phalgu vairagya, false renunciation. Because externally there's renunciation, but in the heart there's still so much desire to enjoy the objects. So ultimately one will have to enjoy again.
Like Mayavadi, they reject all these things, all the beautiful things, that this is Maya, noiti, noiti. Noti means?
No,
this is Maya, this is Maya, rejecting all these things. But Vaishnava knows that if you are rejecting everything, you will die at once. Why not in this way that all the things in whole world are of Krishna, only of Krishna. Nothing is separate from him. So we can utilize all these things as a paraphernalia.
Paraphernalia.
Paraphernalia. and he used it to offer Krishna. And what are essential to maintain our life, we can take. Otherwise, if you are rejecting everything, that it is Mahaprasad Singh, but not Mahaprasad, delicious food you are seeing. Harinam Kirtan, you are seeing like, oh, sound like material sound. Any Vaishnava sing, oh, this is only dead body like that. So, this is Mayavad. So, we should be not Phalgu Vairagya. Phalgu Vairagya means a river in Gaya. Undercurrent. You can see only sands upside. But if you take some sand there, oh, you will see that current is going on. So, externally, we are giving up all rejecting, but by heart, internally, he is wishing so much. So this is Phalgu-vairagya. Or market vairagya. Monkeys has no, nothing, no houses, nothing. But always their sight is there, where any fruit, vegetable, anything to eat. Always enjoying with
female monkeys.
They have nothing else to do. So their vairagya, nakedness, nothing owning, of his own.
No possession.
No possession.
No, nothing. So this is Phalgu Vairagya, Markat Vairagya. Sometimes Smashan Vairagya. Smashan Vairagya means anyone is dead in India.
Oh, crematorium.
Crematorium.
Eh?
Crematorium.
Crematorium. That anyone has dead and you have taken him
to burial ground.
To burial ground. Yeah. All are weeping. Then you see that, oh, one day all will die. So I also must die. Now I am renounced. I have nothing to do with anyone. And he became so
renounced.
And when he returned to his home, his motherless mother has died. Motherless children were weeping and father saw. At first in burial ground he became like that. But when he returned, all boys were weeping and they came in the life of father. And then again Markat Vairagya went and he began to be attached with them. So these are not Vairagya. These are called Markat Phalgu Vairagya. Go on. You should always note that if bhakti is coming, his two sons are bound to come.
Gyan
and Vairagya. And then Gyan and Vairagya, that Tattva Gyan and
Yukta Vairagya.
Yukta Vairagya are helping always you. Otherwise, if you have no bhakti, there is Gyan and Vairagya, they will pull you, drag you to hell.
It is not possible for an embodied jiva to completely renounce the objects of the senses, but changing the enjoying tendency towards them while maintaining an understanding of their relation to Krishna cannot be called sense gratification. Rup, form, ras, taste, gandha, smell, sparsh, touch, and shabd, sound, are the objects of the senses. We should try to perceive the world in such...
This is more important. Listen it very carefully. What?
We should try to perceive the world in such a way that everything appears related to Krishna.
Yes.
Meaning that we should see all jivas as servants and maidservants of Krishna. See gardens and rivers as pleasurable sporting places for Krishna.
What he told? Oh, Prabhu, what he told?
I was not listening to really. My mind was somewhere else.
Why?
His mind was somewhere else.
Why? Why? You should repent. For a moment you should stand up. Again here, you should read.
We should try to perceive the world.
I know who are not hearing. I'm not mentioning. I will mention them and I will tell them also to stand up. All. I know. Some consideration towards half of these. Some. Not fully. But no consideration, no
concession
to you all. Especially red cloths. Again?
We should try to perceive the world in such a way that everything appears related to Krishna, meaning that we should see all jeeves as servants and maidservants of Krishna.
Here.
See gardens and rivers as pleasurable sporting places for Krishna. See that all types of edibles are to be used as an offering for his pleasure. In all types of aromas, perceive the aroma of Krishna Prasad. In the same way, see all types of flavors are to be relished by Krishna. See that all the elements we touch are related to Krishna, and hear only Harikatha, or narrations describing the activities of his great devotees.
How we can see? Now you can see, but be attentive. Don't take your like hearing, but oh, we will know very now he is not here. Don't do like this. This is important, not that what we are thinking. We have come here expensing so much, so many hundreds of dollars, only to hear, not to take enjoyment or anything. If you are thinking like this, you must be there, not coming here. So fie on your mind. No? Now you can tell.
We should see everything in relation to Krishna. Everything is related to Krishna, everything is for Krishna's service.
How you can see that mountains, rivers, and gardens are Bihar Bhumi of Krishna, enjoyment
places
of Krishna. How we can see?
If you see a tree that is bending over, you can think it's like Vrindavan where the trees are in separation from Krishna. If you see a lake, you can think that it's like Radhakund or Shambhu.
You should see very easily like these. Oh, beautiful gardens. Jogmaya has done. And it is a place for enjoyment of Krishna. Only to remind us that oh, so beautiful gardens, so beautiful mountains, so beautiful women and men, all are for Krishna, to serve Krishna. If this insight is coming, mukti and bhukti. Bhukti will go away, very far away. But really you should don't imitate. Only this is the remedy. If you are seeing beautiful flowers, what we see? Oh, how beautiful and so sweet and soft. Oh, Krishna has made it. Only to remember that, oh, our hearts should be like that. Only for this. So, all things which are seen, we should see related to Krishna and for Krishna. And we can take it and engage in the service of Krishna. You can give to devotees and Gurudev. But if you see that he is engaging in his sense gratification, then to reject that Guru and Vaishnava. Those who are taking an offering in the lotus feet of Radhika, Krishna, and to his Gurudev, in chain, they are really devotees. You can give all these things to Gurudev. But if Gurudev is making his own gratification, sense gratification, that you should at once reject that Gurudev, whoever be he, at once. I know that bona fide guru cannot do like this nonsense. If he is doing, but you should also see that if he is offering all this by mind, how can you realize this? So there are so many things to think. Go on.
When a devotee develops such an outlook, then he will no longer see the objects of the senses as being separate from Bhagavan himself.
Yes, this is a very important thing.
The tendency to enjoy the happiness obtained from sense gratification intensifies the desire for bhakti within the heart of a devotee and ultimately deviates him from the path of bhakti. On the other hand, by accepting all the objects of this world as instruments to be employed in Krishna's service, the desire for bhakti is completely eradicated from the heart, thus allowing Shuddha Bhakti to manifest there.
Try to digest what has been given today and think over this and try to follow, and then we will again hum log kuch aage ki baat kahenge. We will tell, explain tomorrow. Yes, tomorrow. But these are very important to follow all these things. If you are not following, that internally you are not following bhakti, you don't want bhakti, you want only sense gratification or only to avoid
sufferings.
That is mukti. Gaur prema. Very important things. So if we cannot explain whole, but we can take some essence. Kirtan.
Thank you.